Hey, Donbeck. Okay, well, I had my lunch, found the manuals and downloaded them, read through a little bit, and found the kit. It's $28 and change at Holly website, and about the same at Jegg's. Didn't really find it anywhere else yet, but I ordered my parts from Holly last time. They ended up having a dollar cheaper than most of the others, and I don't know, their shipping was $5 or $8 or something. It's $5 to $6, I think. So couldn't really find it on Amazon. It looked like, you know, with the free shipping and all that, or would have probably just got it there. But anyway, well, I ended up having to write down to make sure I was getting the right thing, so it turned out the best way to get the right thing. But yeah, these threads I buggered up here. Where's my thumb? Right there above my thumb. That one there, it's boogered up. That's why I couldn't get that jet to go in good. And it's a coarse thread. And I already measured it a while ago, but it's that's pretty much it. No, that's not it. Is it? This is an old dial caliper. I don't have any of those digital ones. This tap is a... Is it a quarter 20? Yeah, that's a quarter 20. I've got more of those. I have a quarter... This is not a bottom tap. Those threads look like... Maybe about the same. This is not a bottom tap, and that's what I need for that shallow hole. Let's see if that'll... You know what? I think that's quarter 20 thread. Pretty darn close to it. It might be close enough I can just clean it up with it. It'll spin all the way around down there with it, you know, in the teeth. So, let me go back and get... I already put all that stuff back. I saw two more. I thought, well, those are quarter 20s. I didn't even bother to check, see what this one was. I didn't think it was that big. I just remembered them. So let me run back and get those. I know I have a quarter 20 bottom tap up there. I don't think this one will go. Let's see if this one will go in there for it. Maybe this will work because it's tapered on the end. Let's see if it'll go into the one that's good. I think it's already bottoming out like I thought, because it's pretty long. The threads don't start really, it's tapered a lot, and it doesn't start until way on up there, and that hole's not even really that deep. Go get that bottom one. Okay, I'm back. Let's see. Got a nice old rusty. I think this is it. Nice old rusty quarter 20. Blow it out a little bit. There's another one. That's a hole tap. Yeah, it's a quarter 20. Pretty sure this one is too. Let's stick the... Yeah, I think that's a quarter 20 bottom tap. I didn't know it had got... I don't know. Sometimes they get in the wrong place. Water gets in the wrong place and rust my stuff up. It must have been in... It was probably in my drill box. I think I used to keep these things in my box, my electric drill kit. Probably got wet or something. I don't know. Sometimes I put them in a different place for a while, lose them, and then I find them again. I usually don't lose them. I usually just don't remember where I put them. Blow it off a little bit. See if it looks like it's clean enough to try and use. I think so. It's got a bunch of crap in it. It'll just do more harm than good. W40 on it. Yeah. I guess we can try getting a little closer.
Where's the carburetor?
Not that close.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put a thread in there. Try the other one first again. If it goes in there, that one's not bad, so if it goes in there. I don't think it's the same. It's not the same thread. That jet's probably a pipe thread of some sort. No, not the same. Same size, pretty much, but not the same thread. So I'm gonna go put these up and get something a little smaller than that big old cutting. Maybe the end of my file, my little triangle file, what the heck do you call them? Maybe the end of that will do it. I guess I've already went through all this before and I had no luck. Put my calipers up. Mess them up out here. Okay, let's see. I don't think the point will go in there. Am I even looking at the wrong one? I think the last time when I found it, it was turned that way. Okay, I think I realized now which one. Oh, I forgot to mention. Whenever I was blowing out, I went after I turned off the camera and I decided to blow out this back bowl, just get the dust out of it from the bad gas. And I was blowing on this and seeing if the float worked. You know, I'd raise it up and bring it down. And the old O-ring from the old transfer tube was I never could see it, even when I looked in there today after I had it apart. It must have went way down in there, and then when I was blowing on it when it was closed, it popped back out and went around my air blower nozzle. So it wasn't gone, it was in there. I don't think it was causing trouble, because the secondaries is the only thing that seemed to be working at the time. But I'm glad to get it out of there. Yeah. It's old and no good. Actually, it's not completely ruined, but I don't want it. That's for sure. I'm not even going to leave it in there. I don't want to forget and wonder if it's a good part. Let's see. Let's get up here a little closer and get out of the sun, since I can't see anyway. Now I've already forgot which one's good. You can tell when you start trying to put them in there. That one goes right in. Okay. I can't see. Even with a little bitty tiny, this magnifying glass has a small area where you can get really close, you know, close up with it. Okay, now it went in there. So I guess it's not as bad as I thought it was. That's the one that went in there. I'm not going to keep scraping around on it and messing with it. If it'll go in there without any resistance, that's fine. But I don't believe I've cleaned them up any. Really. I don't think they cleaned themselves up when I was eating lunch. Okay, so I'm gonna blow it back out from the back way again before I pull it in. I don't need them in there. I'm going to get a kit, because I don't know what kind of shape that is in, or the accelerator pump, you know, the rubber or whatever kind of material it is. I don't know what kind of shape it's in on any of it. So kind of just don't like those big old holes open. I mean, at least the jets, I don't know. I'm going to end up blowing it out before I put it back. I'll move them off. That way I'll know I can see in there, and I'll, you know, it's going to, with me cleaning on it and getting it, I'd rather not have the big holes that I can clean out easier than these little ones of the jets. I think I might get new jets in there, kid. The picture was one picture and it was tiny. Couldn't make it big enough to see what all was supposed to come with it.
water.
The sun's really getting down on the end. It moves quite rapidly. So, I think I'll move my little thing back so that I can get more in the shade. Let's see, is that going to do it? I think that'll work. Yeah, that can get wherever I want in the shade there. It'll move before I get seated again. Can't shade that there. This is good. Okay, yeah. I think I've blown out to what I can get to right now, and that one that I did see the goop in, it's clean. So that's good. I still don't, didn't quite figure out where the passageway went, though. Oops, I was trying to see if it was running. Can't tell the color hardly. I didn't spend a lot of time on those, looking at those instructions. I wanted to get back out here before it got too hot to be out here. It's gonna be hot. Now I can take the bottom plate off. And yeah, last time I may or may not have even taken off the choke. No point in taking anything off if you're not gonna replace it, so. I don't think I'll tear it down much more until I get the kit and see what really comes in it. I don't remember if the bottom plate needs to come off or not. It may. I kind of think it did need to come off to do the kit. Yeah, I see a gasket there. I imagine it does. But I don't want loose parts rattling around, getting lost and getting dirt in them. It's safer put together. Until I get the parts, and then I can take it down and, oh, that's where that vacuum line was that came out. Yeah, the one that stayed in the hose. That's real good that it comes out like that. There's the idle, one of the idle jet over here and here, and I think that was one of the things I saw that you get new ones of. Okay, the only thing that I might want to take off is this. That's got some funky deals. What in the world? It's got rectangular with rounded ends. I didn't remember having a tool like that. And they may not be all that tight. Maybe I just put a small screwdriver in there or something. Like there's maybe still some stuff on there. I just blew at it, sprayed it and blew at it. I guess I didn't wire it again since it dried, because it's coming off like dust now. Yeah, that gasket's still perfect, that one there. I think you get a new one of those. I have to look again. Maybe, I don't know. I'm going to want it off either way, though. I want to see if there's any junk in it because of all this old fuel that was in here. I'm trying to scrape it loose and then I can hit it with the, that carburetor cleaner. It might have cleaned it if I'd have kept spraying at it, but that's, I don't have a whole lot more, and that's pretty expensive. And I don't have nothing to drive to go get anything. I'm having to order everything. Some things come next day, but some things is 2 days plus, you know. So I'm trying to plan that out ahead, too. Not. I ordered some poison for my garden sprayer, because I was almost completely, well, I'm out now as of today, really. It won't spray anymore, really. It's a little sparked here and there, but I got it today. Ordered it yesterday, I think. But I didn't get the other thing. It was supposed to come faster. The other, whatever it was. I got my blue glove, my new blue gloves yesterday. What's the other thing? It's something for the truck, I think. I don't even remember. Oh, no, it was something for the house. We bought a new, on top of all this mess, got a new mirror cabinet for the bathroom, a three-fold. And it was... It needed to do some spackling on the sheetrock, places it's shown now that didn't show before. It has a light in it. Ended up being putting it in up higher. And a little bit of space at the bottom that used to be hidden is now shown. So, got that yesterday. Yeah. And whatever else it is I ordered. Oh, iron-on patches for my pants. They were supposed to come sooner, I thought, but they didn't come sooner. They hadn't got here yet. They could come this afternoon. Sometimes they do. Sometimes you get two or three different people bringing you stuff in a day when you order from, like, Amazon or something. Sometimes you get different shippers bringing. Sometimes UPS will bring stuff from Walmart, and then the post office will bring other stuff from Walmart. The girl, she told me that they contract for UPS, the post office does now. So when they're too busy, they'll send it over to them to take. I just thought that the shipper chose them, you know. I didn't realize they were actually working with. UPS. Alright, let's get the air blower. Actually, I think I will. Well, I'll blow it off some and then I'll spray it. Yeah, this bowl's full of gunk still. This one's really not too bad. It's okay. I sprayed it, and I mean, I didn't. Didn't have to go nuts cleaning it, I guess. I guess this back one was actually in worse shape with gunk in it than the other one was from the old bad gas. Varnish. Ooh, careful. I don't want to mess up the adjustment of the choke. It's always been okay. I mean, the float. I saw this, how to set the float in those instructions. But it's working. I do know that because I tested it a minute ago. Thank you. parts I've ever. See if I can order some of that. I need some more. Need something. Actually, I did see that you could use carburetor cleaner, denatured alcohol, and they mentioned some other kind of common thing. I do have some denatured alcohol. I'd actually rather. That don't bother my skin as bad as carburetor cleaner. It may work better. I haven't tried it. Of course, it don't spray. It's just in a can. You rub it on the rag. But it's kind of what I need to do now. Because I'm not going to spend $7 a can just to blast that thing and then have it. You may never blast it all off. Trying to keep it from spraying up in my face, and the darn hose came off. Oh, this would be kind of dry, huh? Okay. It pushes the pump Oh, but there was some goop in there. Dadgummit. I don't know if you can see it, but there's some goop right there that came out when I did that. Watch where I'm at. I just figured out how to, one way to get that spring out from under the float. I didn't want it out really, but it had the goop. It was in the way of getting that goop out of there. Now the sun right behind the clouds and I can't, it's not enough for me to see even though it feels awful good. Yeah, there's a hole there and a hole up in there, and when I blew through there, and it's when the float goes up it closes, and when the float goes down it opens. But that's where I was able to blow that gasket sealer, calling it goop. That's a gasket sealer that turned into goop. So don't put gasket sealer on this carburetor. Yeah, there's something else. I know the spring's out, but that's not falling back down. The pin. Oh, now it is. Oh, it's kind of sticky. So that pin, the valve pin itself, it's kind of sticky. You know, that may be what we get new, though. That may be what we get new. That freed it up for now. I don't know, I'm putting a lot of effort into seeing if I can make that. I just want to make sure I got it cleaned out. I might get to where it would work. My plan is to get a kit though, I believe. The other one, see how it belongs. Okay, a big on the bottom and it goes all the way up around that little pin. That was kind of sticky too. Not as bad though. So, still trying to figure out if I can tell. Now it's doing all right. It really has to be vertical to work right, I guess. Now it seems fine. Okay. Let's look again. Oh, I see. Oh, it goes over that little plastic tab. Okay, now I know. It came out when I didn't really plan on it coming out. I guess I know where the general area where my camera shot is, but I don't know for sure if I'm in the right place. Okay. There's a bit of moisture coming through there now, but they say don't leave the carburetor cleaner on the rubber parts. That's part it can eat them up. I'm sure you already knew that, but I guess the moisture might be better for it. Well, I don't see why it would be, really. I would put WD-40 in there, but I don't know. That could be worse. I would think it would be better than that cleaner, though, as far as not hurting it. Shoot, if I leave it overnight, that WD-40 in there, I mean that water from coming out of my air compressor, that can be bad. I can rust something up. This one doesn't have a, does have a, air was coming out the fuel inlet there, so I had to plug it up with my finger to get it to, you know, blow through it like I wanted it to. It feels good and strong, the accelerator pump does. Of course, that's the spring I'm feeling, I think. I believe it has a spring behind it. Now the needle's working good there. Okay. I think I'll flip them over once we get them blown out to kind of make sure I'm filling through the dust when I'm blowing on this one. Come on, dirt off there. gotta have the front ones all the way open, then you can open the back one. Right there that I think maybe that's where it's supposed to come through and then go in, you know, be coming from here and going this way if I'm blowing backwards, because if anything was flowing that way and got clogged it up and won't blow the other way and get it back out easier most of the time. But I'm not feeling anything that's through there. May not be the right way. I couldn't feel it with my finger, but I can feel it with my face when I'm... Just because I heard the secondary's opening don't mean that I actually had, you know, fuel, that fuel was coming out of both of them and everything like this year. Running out of pavement over here. I had to put one end of this door off the pavement. Let's see. Back this camera up though. I got a little more room here to back up. Okay. This cardboard is giving me more space. There's a big hole in this door where it used to have a return air vent for an air conditioning system. It was a kitchen door. But they made their garage into like a den, just like our kitchen door, neighbor's door. They put out on the curb when they remodeled. Okay, so, maybe one of these little screwdrivers will... We'll turn that off for a minute there. Press it. It don't fit. This is the one I think I've got that might fit in there. That's so loose.
Wow, that's loose.
I guess that's why I didn't need a fancy tool. Why is it so loose? I guess I'm showing it pretty good, ain't I? Yeah. So I took the dirty carburetor and clogged up the front end of it with gasket sealer, trying to make things better. So, again, kids, don't do what the old people do. Sometimes the instructions are right. Don't do what the shade tree mechanics do. Don't put gasket sealer on there, because some of the older people always tell me, don't put gasket sealer on your carburetor. I don't remember seeing it on anything lately. I just remember it from when I was young. Sure, maybe I did, but I don't care how careful you think you are, boy, when you close that bowl up. Now this is the other side now. I didn't put any on it. I didn't take this side off. This side was just still full of crap from the bad gas that sat in there for 2 years. And this actually wasn't clogged up miraculously. As far as I can tell, it was working. I mean, it sounded like it was working, and you would rev up to no end, and you had to let off before you blew the motor up. It was the whole idling and... idle was fine at first, and then, and see, the gasket sealer went in there. I couldn't understand why it was idling so good, and then suddenly, just boom, wouldn't even idle. And on top of that, it, from the very beginning, it wouldn't, you give it any gas and it would die, or want to die. And that's because it was getting flooded, I know that now. I don't want to tear that up, but I keep from it. Stuck at the top than it was at the bottom. Or the other way around or something. I'm almost thinking about putting it back together or trying it, but because it, like I said, it hasn't been that long, many years since it. I mean, I didn't have to put a kit in it for the first 20 years I had it. So, that's why I think, well, after, you know, I don't know, 3 years, 5 years, whatever it's been since I put that kit in there. And everything looks like it's fairly okay. I'm not sure what holds that. Oh! What holds it is another screw that I didn't take out. Those seem to be so loose that they could have vibrated out and landed in the bottom of the bowl. But that's why I'm fiddling with it, blowing it out. Well, they send the instructions in there, installation instructions for the kit to blow all the orifices out, whatever word they use, passageways. So that's what I've been doing. Get too hot to be any fun now. This part here seems to be kind of hanging on, this metal part. Had a new kit, I would try a little harder at prizing it, but I don't have it, so I don't 100% know. There we go. Yeah, it was just, we were just stuck by the gasket, to the gasket. Okay, yeah, it's got some residue in there from the bad gas. But all the holes look open. Those ones that I did, well, of course, I already knew they were. I blew through them, but I'll get up, try to show it closer in a minute. Does have some stuff in there that would have probably broken loose at some point and maybe gotten into the wrong place. So that's a passageway, valve body sort of thing. And and this gasket here. I'll get my other kit and see if I have any gasket.